What time is it, my creatives? That's right, it's photo hacking time, and it's Charlotte Salcedo, your host. And today we're going to be discussing what's new in Main Type 11 Professional Edition. And we are going to go over everything on how to set this up. Now, in the previous video, I'm showing you here on the screen, we went over how I organize my fonts, because you guys particularly wanted to know that. In the previous version of Main Type 11, it didn't allow you to organize your fonts within the software, but good news, the new version does, so we're going to go over that. So let's get into it. So in my last video, we installed this font called Alienator, as you could see, and when I told you, when I deleted my my root database here that hooked up to my external hard drive, I told you guys that it would resync, but because I had two programs open at the same time and I probably needed to restart my computer, it wasn't working. So I'm showing you here that the font is now showing up, and here I can go ahead and just activate this font, and then it's going to show up in Photoshop for me. And the good thing about this new updated main type version is that when I go to the database on my hard drive here, I just, not this one, when I click here, because this is my root folder, okay? So now when I drag and drop any fonts in here, it's going to update automatically. I do not have to hit the refresh button. And that's one of the newer features in Main Type 11 Professional Edition. So kudos for that. So another thing that I love about the new feature in Main Type 11 is that you can drag and drop and just basically organize your interface here the way you want. Now, you can't put this anywhere you want. It's got to like highlight like that. And then you can just pretty much drag and drop how you want things to go. Now, if you ever want it to go back to the default settings, and I wouldn't suggest doing this when you're new, because when you're new, when you're following the directions in the manual, it's kind of hard to follow along if you've drag and dropped all these different interfaces in different places, and then it doesn't look anything like the manual. So if you want to go ahead and reset that, it's very easy to do back to factory settings. And what you would do is you'd go to View, Load Layout, and then Restore Factory Layout. And then what it's going to do, it's going to put it back to the way it was. Now, another thing that I love is that it also gets rid of duplicates automatically. And then you could see the characters and the additional wingdings and all of the different additionals over here in a separate palette. And you could search up any font, it will pop up over here. And let's just put in H. If you don't remember the name of the font, you can just type in something in here and it will just start, generating different fonts for you. And then you can also look at the library. You can see the recently added fonts here, the top rated fonts. You can tag your fonts, you can add keywords to them. So those are a lot of cool new features that have been added here. And you should definitely look into this. So here you can see that these are all my recently added fonts, and you can see Alienator is right there at the top of the list. So not only do we have the new features of customizable layouts, notes, tags, and ratings, and Unicode character grids, we also have in-depth font comparison. Now, in order to view the in-depth font comparison, you're going to go up to here to View Panels, and then you're going to choose View Panels, I'm sorry, it's already out, so the Information Panel. So if you click on it, it's going to go away. So if you go to View Panels, Information Panel, you can compare five fonts side by side. So I'm comparing these alien fonts side by side. So I'm going to delete these so I can show you how it's done. So I'm going to go into this folder here. Let's see. Let's compare Art Deco fonts here. Actually, let's do something different. Let's compare some decorative fonts. Okay, so how you do this is in order to drag these panels over here, and you can dock this panel. When it came out, it was over here, but I just pulled it up so you guys could see this a whole lot better. And the only way that you can compare this, you have to activate them first. And so you'll just click the button and then you'll just drag it over here and into the panel, and it should go ahead and work. And I'm not sure why this one's not working. Okay, so yes, it's over here in the panel, and yes, sorry. Cifi Sortelogy. Okay, so it's up here. So now I'm going to, this font here is already Explorer. So this one is already activated. So you can just click on it and it pops up in here. So you don't actually have to drag it. But the directions say to drag it. So if you click on it, and it will just change up here, but it won't actually stick. So I'm going to just explain to you what I mean. So if you drag this up here, it will come to there, and then drag that up there and it will come in there. So if you don't actually drag it, it'll just change it in here. So see what I mean? It's just, it's not actually like changing it in there. So I'm going to activate this one and then drag it out in here. And so now we have 1, 2, 3, 4. We can have one more that we can compare, and I'm going to activate this one. And I'm going to drag it out here. And so now you can compare these fonts, the different information that's in here given to you, the license information, the metrics, all of that. I guess this would be a feature that a more advanced professional designer would need. But the feature is here if you're using it. I don't see how beginners would actually use this. I particularly like using this because you can see from a glance that this has 58 extra glyphs. This one has 311. If you're looking for something really, you know, specific, what type of family type, you could see that this one, this particular font seems to be more well designed because it has more information in it. It's just, you know, it's whatever, but it lets you compare different fonts, you know, the different information in there, who's designed it, the licensing and all of that. So yeah, so that's a really cool feature that's been added in the new Main Type 11 Professional Edition. So another new feature is the print preview, which I find is really cool. I'm just going to pick up one of these fonts and I'm going to do the print preview on this. So I'm going to file print preview. And the cool thing about this is that it prints out a little page of the fonts. And this is so cool because I've always thought about like making an external book of all my fonts so I could look at them, because I'm such a visual person. And I think this feature is so cool. The other thing is that you can preview this, and you could probably make a little PDF book of your fonts. So if you just zoom in to like, you can zoom in to 100%. I think this is a free font, so it doesn't have like all of the different glyphs and stuff like that, that you have to pay for it. So this is like a free font. But as you can see, this is really cool, and you can print this. And you can print it as a PDF, and you can save this and send this to your clients as well so they can see the font. Or you can, you know, use this as part of like a case study or something like that. I don't know, but I think this is really, really cool, and I really like this feature. So that is part of the feature that you, and there's all these different additional things, settings and stuff that you can add too. But we're not going to go deep into that because I don't want to bore you. I definitely recommend getting the software and playing around with it though. So So the next new feature is that you can create and store backups on the fly. So remember in my previous video, I had talked about how I'm always making backups and backups of my backups. So now you can create backups with just a few clicks. You just go to Tool and Create and Restore Backups. And I've already created a backup, so I'm not going to do that, but that feature is there for you. So some of the cool new features is that you can actually sort your fonts by a number of different things, by classification, by symbol, italic, full name, weight, width, foundry, rating, notes, tags. What I had mentioned before is that you have the notes, tags, and ratings that you can also add to this as well. And I believe that there was this feature in the previous one, but I guess this one is a little bit more advanced. You can also create groups of your fonts now. Now you see how I have already grouped my fonts and I already did this outside of the software. Well, now you can do it internally by just clicking this button and creating a new group. And this one you can name. Actually, I hit the wrong button. This one is for the root group folder, setting it up. And you can also use this to sync with other people. You can put it on a network. You can add user access. So those are new features as well. But to add a new group within here, so basically think of a group as like a folder name. And you would just name it like whatever, like my carrot fonts. I'm just making something up. That's the first thing that came to my head. I don't know why carrots are on my mind. I don't know. And then you could put a short description. You can even change the icon, which is really cool. Something, you know, a little snazzy that you can remember or something like that. And then you add it. And that creates your little folder in there. And then you can add fonts to that folder. So that's a really cool new feature as well. I think one of my favorite features is repair the font registry and then also deleting duplicates. So before, the system did an okay job of deleting duplicates, but a lot of the stuff you had to manually click, like refresh the database. Now it does this automatically. So to initially set this up, you're going to create the root folder. My root folder is, if I browse out here, I go to my fonts folder. This is on my external drive. It's basically, in order to sync up your font folder on the external drive, you have to call it back to the software. And that's exactly what this is doing. So this is a file folder path that's in here. And so basically it's going to index all of the subfolders in there automatically and then create groups after indexing, only available when adding a folder. And then you can keep this in sync automatically and it will sync every 60 minutes. You can choose how you want this to sync. Remember, the more you have it syncing, the more memory and hard drive space that it takes. So I wouldn't set this to, if you don't add fonts to your folder like so often, I would just put this like every day or something. I don't know if that's an option, but I mean, you could figure that out in minutes, but I would leave it at the default. And then this option here, automatically install all fonts from folder after synchronization. And this is the professional edition only. And then smart install. If a similar font is already installed, it will be uninstalled. And then you just click that. And then you can also click user access so other people can have access. So that is cool. I'm just going to cancel out because I already have mine set up. And then if you want to do this manually, of course, you can just click on this little folder here. This is to set up your folders here. And then you would click on that and you can either refresh, modify, refresh all, and that will update that. You can also click here to update and open the registry fixer to fix any registry problems that you have manually. So the next thing that we have here is you have the open type layout features and you can use the sample panel and select which features you want to apply to the previous text so you can test the font see how it looks with different colors. And all you have to do is just press this little X2 button and you can come in here and type whatever you want. So I'm just going to come in here and type hello. This is my text. And then you can change the size, of course, how it will look. And of course, this is like a gritty type. You could change the color here. You can also change the background. So you could see how it would look in Photoshop before activating it. Now, personally, this is not my way of, I personally don't use something like this. I actually like to activate my fonts and look at them inside of Photoshop. So I kind of already know what kind of font I'm looking for. As you can see, I'm very detailed with my folders and how I organize them. So I already know what kind of style of font I'm looking for. And I basically just grab a few from that particular theme and have them activated, and I'll activate them and look at them in Photoshop. But that's my personal preference. You could do whatever you want, but I'm just letting you know that feature is there if you're into that, and I know a lot of you are. So kudos to that feature. So these are some of the top features that I particularly like. I don't want to make this video too long. It's already like going on 20 minutes. So let me know what you guys think about these new features. And as always, if you like this video, hit the thumbs up, hit that bell, like, and subscribe. Thank you so much, guys, for watching. Have a great day.